Hi, welcome to Coastal Kitchen. I'm Rupa here, and the Christmas is over, and let's start with some healthy cooking because we've eaten a lot of pastries and a lot of Christmas turkey. So I'm going to do a very simple recipe called as tomato saar. It's quite a hit in the coastal side because tomatoes are loved by all the generations. Even the youngsters love it and the old love it. So let's go something very special with the tomatoes called as tomato saar. Okay, as the name suggests, it's tomato saar. Saar is nothing but a thin curry preparation in the Konkan side. It's called as saar. So anything that you do very thin for in a curry, it's called as a saar. The tomatoes, so that we are using a lot of tomatoes here, approximately 4 to 5, depending on the size. These are blanched, but we're going to use the skin. Blanching is nothing, I've just put the tomatoes in hot water for about 2 minutes and drained them out. So we put the tomatoes in the mixie and required to grind it with along with the coconut. So put the tomatoes into the mixie jar. We have some fresh grated coconut, so we'll require that, approximately about 2 tablespoons of it. So put them in the along with the tomatoes. This is just to give a little taste and the body to the saar, and in being in the Konkan, coconut is a must for all the preparations. So we added that. What we do is we just temper some jeera or cumin seeds just to add a little flavor when we are grinding it. So we're taking a tempering bowl, let it go nice and hot, and then add about just about half a teaspoon of ghee. We'll require the rest of the ghee for the later tempering. So about half a teaspoon of ghee. And we have some cumin here. This is whole cumin. Once the ghee goes hot, add that. It's about a teaspoon of cumin. Yeah. Let that just crackle. I can get a nice aroma of the cumin roasting in the ghee. Yeah, you can hear it crackling. Just shut the gas. And this crackling cumin, we put it along with the tomatoes for grinding. We'll grind it to a nice fine paste. I've not taken off the skin because I try to keep the skin if it's required, unless you want to really cut them fine or something. But if you're just grinding, the skin always adds body and a little roughage to the diet. So add about a cup of water. Yeah, just check whether it's ground to a nice, the tomatoes are finely ground along with the coconut and the cumin. As you can see, it's got a lovely color, and let's take it for cooking. So what we do is we take a pan, a nice deep pan, put it on stove. And then we have this, the remaining of the ghee. We have used about half a teaspoon. The remaining half teaspoon is there. We'll take that for tempering. So add that into the pan. Let it go nice and hot. The ghee gives a nice flavor and an odor to the saar that we are making. There's not many ingredients that have gone. It's basic ingredients that you have in the house. I'm sure you should try it for your family. With the winters and tomatoes plenty in the market, that's a recipe I think you should definitely try. Yeah, the ghee is melted. Yeah. For the tempering, as I said, basic ingredients are there. This is some mustard seeds. So, half a teaspoon of mustard seeds. The mustard seeds are crackling, so we'll put the curry leaves. We'll toss in the hing. And the turmeric powder. Okay, so the temper is done. In goes the ground tomatoes. Okay, give it a stir. You can see that it's got a lovely orange color. For the fieriness, we'll add little chili powder, about half a teaspoon. Give it a stir. This is a nice tangy sweet sour that I'm making, so we'll add some green chilies also later for the flavor of the green chilies. Gives a nice flavor when it gets cooked. This is cooking, adjust the water. As I said, it's a thin one, so adjust the water. Yeah. You can see that the saar or the curry, what I've done with the tomatoes, has come to a boil. At this stage, just add about one green chili for the flavor. I've just cut it into nice big pieces and some salt. Give it a stir. And add the jaggery. Again, give it a stir and let it simmer for about 2 minutes till the jaggery melts and the salt and the jaggery incorporate a lovely flavor into the saar. When you serve, just add some coriander leaf chopped. I've kept it already chopped, so just add the coriander leaves which are chopped and serve it with lovely steamed rice. As you saw, the tomato saar is ready. The just staple ingredients have gone into it. In case you're tired after a work and you come home, you need not even make the rice. As I was just pouring, I just realized it's got a lovely consistency. You can thin it down and serve it as an Indianized tomato soup. So if you have liked this recipe, please subscribe, like it, and share it with friends.